Alrighty. It's a Monday evening. My goodness. And welcome to the channel, folks. I am Super Pack. And London Last is back here with us as well. And I've been maintaining this for quite some time. I can't stand daylight savings time. Never have. So there's that. I live in a place where it really doesn't matter so much. It's generally quite sunny during the summer months. In fact, this morning when I went out to walk my dog, it was quite dark outside when it's normally not. So I'll have to get used to it. I remember a time where I live, we didn't do that, but now we do. Anyway, hey, welcome to the program. We're going to do some LaserDisc gaming tonight. We're going to see how bad I am at the game Road Blaster. Now, let's go back to the LaserDisc era of the 1980s, shall we? Dragon Slayer had made its mark, and it did some pretty good sales. It captured a lot of players wanting to beat the game, wanted to see all the animation that was in it, and it turned up a pretty good penny. So, what to do? So, a lot of companies wanted to get into that type of, business, if you will. And a lot of companies did jump in here in America. We had Sega jump in and Bally Midway.
And beg your pardon?
Looks like Vin agrees with you over the time.
Hey, Vin. Hey, I'm sorry. I didn't see you there. Jumping back or going back is pointless. Just stick with one. Oh, I agree. I absolutely agree. I think that we should stick with standard time. Because I already got no from London Lass. London Lass likes it really sunny. She likes the sun setting during the summer solstice at 9 p.m.
That's what I'm used to.
That's what you're used to. Well, I'm not. So, I agree. We should stick with one, but I if we're going to stick with one, it should be, daylight savings time. Daylight standard time.
Nope, you're right. First time.
No, I'm not.
BST.
Standard time. I'm not going to give you my first answer.
BST.
Standard time.
BST.
I didn't realize we had a fuel crisis to require that extra hour of time. Well, yeah, it's a long story. But they actually extended daylight savings times here a couple of administrations ago or so to conserve extra fuel and whatever like that. It's political. I'm not going to get into it, but I don't like it. I've never have. I never will. Or light, yes.
And you don't trust Klingons either.
I don't trust Klingons either, that's right. Anyway, going back to the Dragon's Lair, so a lot of companies decided to jump on that kind of success, and did it both here and abroad. And we're going to take a look at one of the games here that made it popular in Japan called Road Blaster. So let's take a look at Road Blaster, shall we? There it is for its poster. And it looks pretty exciting just by the looks of it itself. You drive that really fast red car right there. Oh, absolutely. And just by the title screen alone, you probably can get an idea of what's going on. You and your sweetie are out in the road. You just got married. And this gang comes up and, they flip over your car and she winds up dying. And, of course, that means you're going to go on a revenge spree of sorts.
Oh, it's Mad Max.
Kinda. It's kind of like Mad Max in a way. Except it's in modern-day civilization, or at least it was back in 1985. Now, the arcade game itself didn't make it in America's arcades. It largely stayed over there in Japan, and it was made by Data East. However, we did get something of it here in America, and it was for the Sega CD at first, called Road Avenger. And I have to admit, I have a Sega CD here. I bought it for the LaserDisc games, particularly Dragon's Lair. But this was like an added bonus. This was done by Renovation along with Wolf Team, who did it out in Europe. And if you were like one of the three people who bought the Laser Active, this was an actual video game console here that took LaserDisc. They also had some add-on packs that you could play your Sega Genesis on and a few other things. And it was mildly expensive. It was up there with the Neo Geo pricing, per se. It cost you several hundred dollars if you want to play it. And the games themselves were pretty big. But, of course, it doubled as a CD player, so it had a modicum of practical use as opposed to playing your LaserDisc movies, should you still have any. and of course playing the LaserDisc game itself. And this was the game that was released for LaserActive. That would be Road Prosecutor for us in America. And also elsewhere overseas, you did get Road Blaster or even Road Avenger. And not to be confused with Road Blasters from Atari. This was a different game coming out a year later, where you kind of, almost the same thing, except you didn't have a girl and you weren't avenging her passing thing.
Oh yeah, that's exactly the same thing.
Well, for some reason, Road Blaster and Road Blasters get confused, just simply from the name. The Me Too product. In a way, yeah, so, again, the LaserDisc technology was taking off. The arcades died off here in America, but not so much in Japan. And they continued going on in 1985. You got to remember, 1985, they debuted with the Nintendo Famicom, hoping to bring it out here in America with Atari's partnership. That, of course, didn't happen. And we kind of know what happens otherwise. So there's a bit going on here. I like to think that, I mean, I enjoy the LaserDisc games. A lot of them have a very similar feel to one another. They're either point and click, if you will, or they superimpose regular 8-bit or 16-bit graphics over the scenery that the LaserDisc provides. LaserDisc trend chasing, I mean, we see it today with the push for 3D in the 2010s and now again with VR. Well, I'll say this about VR. The sustainability of actually making it a product that can be used properly. I mean, yeah, we see YouTube videos of people crashing into TVs, furniture, themselves, other people, falling in midair for no apparent reason. Okay. But as far as the computers being able to use it properly and giving proper graphics and us as the audience being able to see what they have, yeah, it's finally out there to a point where it's sustainable. I don't see Ready Player One level yet. Neither. And as you say there, and hope we don't. Agreed. I think that's a little bit out of control, but that's another story for another day. So, let's get the LaserDisc emulator. This is Daphne fired up here. I'm going to hit pause for just a second, and we'll be right back. And we'll give this one the arcade treatment, of course, because it was indeed an arcade game. Alrighty. Blank screen is just frozen on the first screen. Let's go ahead and let it go through its test real quickly. And there it goes. Oh, and that's going right to this, right to the theme. So take a gander. This tells you everything you need to know without even playing the game. Road Blaster. It is a cartoon, yes. You see, there's thugs terrorizing the city, destroying storefronts, making people run for their lives. And of course, you and your bride, oh, just got married. Oh, there they are, up to no good. Here we go. Yep. Oh dear. No, that was the flower that she was wearing in her hair. Shedding that one single tear, and now the garage reopens with a souped-up car. Ready to go. Now you have things like here, you have to steer your car left and right, that's kind of rudimentary. There's the DJ. Your typical 80s disc jockey.
Hey, here's some good news for you. You've all seen that
That's the one. That's right. He's blasting them sky high. Hey, red supercar, can you hear me out there? The gangs are running wild again. Hurry, man, we need you. We need you fast. Absolutely. We do need him. Now. So you have an accelerator that you have to actually aim to accelerate. You can't just accelerate willy-nilly. And you have, what you call it there? Actually, I should probably highlight it right here. There we go. And you have a braking. You have to brake and so you don't crash into things. Can I pause it now? Yes, okay. So you don't crash into anything. So there's a bit of timing. There's a bit of speed. Certainly skill. And a tremendous amount of memorization. Sounds just like Dragon Slayer in a lot of ways, except you're in a car now instead of a knight. Okay, so let's restart that. I'm going to put a credit in. Hey! Cantina is playing there too. All right, cool. Got the sound thingies to work there. Sound thingies? Yes. Alrighty. Let's get this going as we hit start. Let's go. Thank you very much. There's me steering right, left, and right. Oh, I'm perpetually also on the gas pedal. And I have to avoid these cars that I'm driving recklessly into. And here comes the braking system. Oh, I almost hit the wrong button. Good job. Oh, trying to stay onto the road here without going through the guard there. Crash that car. Heck yeah. Oh. Oh. Oh, wasn't in the box enough there. Could almost pass for a PS1 game. I'll tell you about that in a second. Oh. Crashing the people. Nope. Just you know how probable this is. I've got an extra life. None of it matters. I put this on limited lives. Guess I can't continue otherwise. Oh! Oh! Goes right on outside the car. God, got ejected. Could almost be a PS1 game. Yep, it could have. Thank you very much. Ah. Just waiting for the Wilhelm scream. Oh! Yeah, bye-bye. Thank you for the mega fart. It almost blended with the game a little too well. Thought there was an extra motorcycle sound. Okay, I'm not hitting the brakes, what's happening. I gotta brake and turn left. I got this. Thank you for the Mario death. As odd as that sounds. I'm just having a little too much fun with the sound streamers. Yeah, neck. No! Oh my goodness! My job typo test them all. Yes, thank you. The ones that are probably going to get me more is the accelerate and the combo. Thank you. Excuse me. Oh! You would not believe what that sounded like with my headphones. There we go, finally made that one. Thank you. No. Ah, damn. Damn. Oh, it's gonna start me all the way back here. Screw you. My penance. Thank you. Okay. Oh, wasn't in the box. Damn. Thank you. Oh, chicken dance. Excellent. So you finally got a purpose for all those points. Be in the box. Oh, Jesus Christ. We're still on level one, by the way, folks. Remember, it took me 90 minutes to beat Space Ace, a 14-minute game. Thank you. Oh, wrong one. Ah! Now I should be ready for the accelerates. Nope. See, I forgot about that stupid ramp. All right, absolutely. The FBI is always outside my car door. Why was that loud? It is. Sorry about that, Vin. Oh, I heard it. Boy, did I hear it. Yep. They're still scared, even though this is like the 12th time. Yep, got an extra life somehow. There we go. I was that I was that close to getting past level one. That one move. They know you're driving, yes. There we go. Narrow corridors, as this always works out. Blazing speeds. Of course. Oh, psych out. Oh, damn, not fast enough. Can't tie most days on a teeny weeny keyboard. Forget it. Sorry about that, London Lass. Wow, not even, gee, man, that he's not even had it going left. Got past it. Oh, keep going. Oh, bad. That looks so much better from my point of view, though. Interesting. I'm already way ahead of you there. There we go. Level two. Heck yeah. Stage three. Out in the highway. Thank you. No idea what that is. It sounded pretty cool nevertheless. In time to disappoint you. Okay. Try it again. Of course. Oh. Damn. It's a Pokemon level up jingle. Oh, that's what that is. Okay. You're right, I'm disappointed. Damn. They give you virtually no time with that one. I imagine it's kind of like the like Pac-Man's starting sound. You know what it is. Oh. Man. Yep. Near the truck. Avoiding the truck. Re-avoiding the truck. Oh, wrong way. Oh! Oh, wow. That's when it's left. Back to another left, and accelerating over the truck. And a little bit of slippy slip. Yep. Oh. Of course. Absolutely. Oh. Get off. Get off. Ah. Damn. You're in the way. Back to here again. Left. Second left. Accelerate. Jump the truck. Oil spill. Regain your composure. That too. Psychopath. Jumps on the thingy. Man, not enough time. In the 80s, without a mohawk dyeing in an odd color, that's right. Well, it was the mid-80s. Now, unlike Cliffhanger, which we'll get into in this moment, this animation was actually dedicated for this game. Man. Oh. Brutal. Oh my. Quite brutal. Team of Nitties. Man. Another left. A second left. Accelerate. Go, go, go. Cliffhanger relied on material from Lupin the Third. Well, this did not. This was actually made for the game itself. Found out YouTube does not like my using Cliffhanger. Really? It was in the freaking box, you freaking frick. Deja vu. Here we go. Turning right. Turning left. Left again. Accelerate. I think the tough part of this is when you accelerate, you got to keep it in the box there. You can't just accelerate and be done with it. You have to actually aim your accelerate. Really? Because I did it too soon. Yep. Brutal death once again. Man. Ah! Go, go! Okay, left. Right. He lights the thing. Evil laughter. Accelerate city. Jumps on the car. Left. Left again. Got it this time. Yes! Oh. Copyrighted also the cliffhanger was a bad adaption. Cliffhanger was a bad adaption, yes. Oh, this again? Went all the way back here? Damn it. I dare say, I mean, TMS did authorize cliffhanger. TMS owns Lupin the Third. TMS is part of Sega. Having said that, they still hold the copyright to both cliffhanger and Lupin, of course. Yes. Alright. Damn it. Oh, wow. That's a new one. Yep. Number took 90 minutes for Space Ace. We're going for a new record here. Now you get to the point where you're anticipating everything. Yep, there you go. Damn it. I am turning left. Ouch. Let's try this again. Nonetheless, you used up all your points. No? Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah, right, well. Okay, very good. Oh. There we go. We're that close to the end is what happened. Letting them rebuild. I see. Now, you have spent a lot of counter points. Oh. Oh, forgot the brake. Oh, I got first hand to see what the engine looks like, at least. Survive that one. I like the spiked bat. Yep, more no. Damn. I hit the brake, didn't I? Yeah, that probably won't be as effective. Oh, I was in it. Oh, absolutely. Oh, forgot to turn right. Oh, my goodness. Brutal. Some of these deaths are absolutely brutal. Hey, I turned right. Damn. Wrong button, of course. Good job. I'm getting there, folks. We'll make it. Come hell or high water, we will make this. There we go. Oh, of course. We're in a building. Oh. Not over yet, folks. Now it's over. Heck yeah. The other right, that's right. Oh man. Quite a bit there. Oh, saw this in the opening. Hey, Dust. How'd you get in here? All right, lay down there, Dustin.
How you doing?
Oh, there we go. It's like I'm going to do that. Oh, my God. Through the door. Yep. Okay, Dusty, you're scratching my chair there, dude. Thank you. Oh! Oh! Fast! Wow. I'm gonna pause the game for just a second there, folks. I'm gonna hit pause. And I'm gonna hit pause right about here. And we'll be right back. Stand by. All right, Dusty had to go out there.
Okay.
How's everyone doing tonight? Before we kick back into the game, just want to ask, what do you all think so far of Road Blaster? It's a tough game. Like I said, there's a lot of fast action moving from left to right, of course. But of course, you have to sometimes brake and right, brake and left, accelerate, and so forth like that. It's a fast game. Goodness. All right. I particularly liked it. Dusty's now barking up there. Great. All right, so let's go back to the gameplay, shall we? And to the... There it is. Right now the score is 312,800. I have unlimited lives, thank God. And... Let's see if we can get past this one real fast, because I'm going to let this one go ahead and die right about here. Yep, there we go. Okay. Boom! You know, it's going to be here. Right there. And another accelerate anywhere. Oh, man, that fast left, that poor gas station, man. Okay, barely made that one. Okay. Not fast enough, damn. Really? Because I went out of it too fast. Of course. Okay. There we go. Oh, not soon enough. Wow. Okay. Okay. Got it. All right. Dusty's barking up a storm. Everyone's jumping for their lives. Yep. Oh, not soon enough. Wow, that's quite drastic. Wow. Okay then. Oh, don't tell me I hit those kids. Oh, well, almost. Nope. Yep. Damn. I crashed into the helicopter this time. I did last time before, too. You remember the turn down difficulty. This is easy.
He's just that good.
Just that. Sometimes it's just that one split second thing. There we go. Hi, everybody. Don't mind me. What? I do seem... Oh, they're all the way this back this far. Wow, okay. I do seem to be doing a great deal more damage than the thugs could, yes. Oh! Well, it's just like the Marvel movies, you know? The Avengers took care of everything, destroyed half the city, but at least they saved the day. Not fast enough. Hmm. Okay. That. No, so close. So close. Ah. At least I got past that part. Oh. Oh. Had to turn right and accelerate. Oh, accelerated instead. Well, there you go. Not quite the outcome I was looking for. Had to break with left. Oh, there you go. Not quite Blues Brothers worthy. Oh, man. Okay. That's to keep me from flying off that bridge. And there you go. Stage 6. I did hit left. Oh, goody. Of course. Oh, the corkscrew. Nice touch. Oh, not fast enough. And back to the corkscrew. I like the boat. Hey, I was inside the box. Guess not. What? Such a narrow window there. I have such giant crosshair. Guess I have to be perfectly centered. No! No! Okay. There you go. Not bad. Stage 7. Ah, normal everyday traffic. Going into the sewers. Heck yeah. This should be easy peasy. Oh, jeez. Brutal. There you go. Ah, demolition derby inside of a sewer. Perfect. Oh, what's the object of this game? Yes, not to die, not to crash into things. Defeat the bad guy. Oh, wrong button, stupid. You're seeking revenge. Vengeance for your sweetie that was killed by this murderous gang. Really? Oh, wow. By crashing. It seems to be that way. Okay. Oh. Yep, must be pretty good because you got the music kicked back in. Oh yeah. Oh. Braking, accelerating, both the same thing. Oh, nice. Okay. Damn. No, that didn't work out too well. If your brakes cause you to go forward, you have a problem. That is true. That is absolutely true. In this case, however, it seems... In my case, it's a bioelectrical error. Yep, ID 10T. It's a skill issue. And we're still going. I didn't realize how big this gang was. Oh, wow. Yep, yep. Yep, of course. Yep. Yep. Good job. Yep, so much for him. Oh! Ah, got hit by the wheat thrasher there. Okay, see if he's any more successful this time. Somehow I doubt it. Thank you. Of course. Oh, wow. Oh, not fast enough. Once again, being converged on by these trucks. And the gangs on the motorcycle. That's close. Oh! Man, I got pitchforks. Oh! Wow, brutal. Absolutely brutal. Oh, I had to stay accelerating while turning right, but of course. Of course. Makes perfect sense now. Lost pitchforks. Oh. Oh! Yes. My goodness. Did not fare too well. Damn. Thanks for the hype, London Les. Still going. Okay. There we go. Oh. See how far back it puts me. Not too bad. Boy, I do leave a trail of destruction behind me, don't I? Stage 9! Okay, there's my path of destruction. Actually, it's more like theirs, but, you know. The final battle. Good start. What a great start that was. Even got two notes out of the music. Okay. Not bad. That's at least good to hear. I'm not sure how the hell I got out of that one. Oh. Yeah, that's a mess. Oh, wow. Super fast. A different mess. There you go. Boy, I'm just a recluse. Jesus. Wow. Okay. Whoa! Not sure I got out of that one. Oh, Jesus Christ. Don't I have missiles? No, London Lass. I'm not James Bond. I do not have missiles. All that would be nice. Oh, missed it. What's the point? Well, remember, he's going after the bad guys who killed his wife. It's just, in my case, with me being him, he's just really doing it horribly. Jesus Christ. I have to admit, it's a little hard to follow this. Oh, good heavens. Logic in a video game. It happens not too often. It can happen. All the way back here. Holy crap. Thank you. Thank you, London Les. Boosting my confidence. Thank you. Jesus. Thank you. Ah, back to the chicken dance. You know, the music actually almost really goes well with this. Oh! Yes, London is. She certainly is. Okay. Okay. Yep. Yeah. Oh, wrong way. And it's gonna throw me all the way back to that bus. Yep, son of a bitch. Alright. Man. This is a hard stage. It's the final stage of the game, if I'm not mistaken. It has been quite a while since I've actually played this, and this is on the Sega CD. It didn't have quite the accuracy that this one requires, like where to accelerate to, or the fact that the buttons are left and rights are so fast. Man. Okay. Crash. Hopefully, start me somewhere else. Oh, damn. But of course. Oh, thank God. Jesus. Damn. Damn, it's a double left, and I keep forgetting that. Seriously? Oh, wow. Seriously? Man. I double left. Damn it! There we go. Oh, I survived that one. Much better set of wheels now. Oh. Yeah. An axe? That is weird. Yep. That's a Rambulance, yes it is. Way ahead of its time. I was turning left. Okay, you know what? Back to the thumbstick. Come on. Yeah. Jesus Christ. Really? Oh! Trial and error, folks. Trial and error. Can you imagine if I were putting in quarters for this? Damn. So we're now looking at 70 minutes. Sort of. Well, since broadcast. About 60 minutes. Jesus. Oh yeah, I'd be broke. What? Yeah, sure was. Yeah, they wanted your money. This is how they get it. Too soon. Turn. I did hit. My goodness. Well, this was a Japanese game, so I imagine it costs more than your average gameplay. Much like it did over here. I hit. My goodness. Really? Ah, I went the wrong way. Man. Man, oh man. We can get this, folks. I will get this. Okay, U-turn. There we go. Really? Call an ambulance because it just got hit by an ambulance. 45 minutes remaining. I know. I will get through this. It's the damn car. I missed my old car. Jesus Christ. We'll get through this. It takes me the next 45 minutes. I got this part. Jesus Christ. Just as I'm hitting it. So I literally have to be like a half second ahead. Oh, Jesus Christ. How far back? All the way back to... Okay. Damn. Okay. We will make this happen. Never fear, folks. Since I'm anticipating the moves. Oh man. Jesus Christ. This game's nuts. I'm doing a little ahead of the time. Okay, we got this. Okay. And let's do a left, a rather right, and then a left, and then a big ol' right. Yes. Another right, and... Damn. Okay, this is the one. And if not, it'll be the next one. 2, 3. Oh yeah, I can do it. I'm either going just a tad too ahead or a tad too back. Man. Oh, thank you. Ah! Thank you for the cantina. Okay, come on. Ah, Jesus Christ. Alrighty, this is it, folks. First try, here we go. That's the laughter of confidence that you hear back there. Knowing that I can full well beat this game. Every confidence in me, every faith, I can do it. I got this. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, man. You know, you've done well when your wife is laughing at your gameplay. Jesus Christ. How good of a game player is your husband, London Lass? Well, let me tell you. After the gales of laughter die down, and slight hyperventilation, she begins her answer with, "Yeah, sure." Okay, got that part. Jesus Christ!
Hey! Tone it down on the pacing.
Huh?
Tone it down with the pacing.
Oh, man. It wouldn't be so bad if it didn't throw me back all the way here again. Joust and Paperboy, I guess. Ouch, yes, thank you. It's an almost compliment I was just paid. Oh. Jesus. Man. Yeah, no, it wasn't. Yeah, thank you. I was trying to believe that it was. Oh, you locked up again. Et tu, Brute. What? I was in the box. We can do this. I got this. Alright. I got it. I'm gonna be up at 1,000,000 points by the time this is done. Yeah, there you go. I got this. Absolutely. Seriously? Lordy, lordy, lordy. Thank you. Thank you, Lionel S. I think. I'm not giving up. Never give up. Never surrender. Something. That was close. Okay. Oh, the accelerator box is way the frick over there. Are you effing kidding me? And I'm still all the way back here. Man. What? We got this. Okay, come on, we got it. What? Kaboom, yes. If I don't finish this before 9 o'clock, because I do have to be elsewhere, I will finish this up after I'm done with elsewhere. Like it or not. I'm not going to let this game... I'm not going to let this... As I crash, I'm not going to let this game get me. It's a Pinto. You know, it could be. Very well could be. It could explain a lot of things. It's a converted Pinto. Jesus. Ah, lordy, lordy, lordy. Never fear, folks, I will get this. Okay, got that one. They even, yeah. Short sighted of the programmers? Could be. Well, they're getting their virtual money's worth. Geared to the baddies. It's something. Okay, I got this. I got this. That's all right. I get you. Just like when I'm on the phone in chat. It's just tiny, tiny little keys. Virtual keys. Something isn't right here? Yes. Something is not right here. I'm now, wow. Yeah. There has to be a point where I am past this point. Okay. Oh, god damn it. Forgot about that. Is that bar after the end? Yep. Some kind of health? No. This bar up here? No, that's your accelerator. Jesus. Deities have nothing to do with this, yeah. Seems like it. Hey, my score reset. I'm back down to 4,000. Hot damn. Alright, so I'm going for low score now. Yeah. No, I don't think they intended for some bozo here to actually reach a million points playing this game. Well, they got one now. Oh, yeah. Ah, wrong way. Oh, we gotta get this. We gotta get this, folks. Fervent prayer. Here we go. I can get this. Just gotta remember my rights from my lefts. Or my other rights versus my other lefts. Absolutely. Thank you, Ben. Oh, it'll work. Just gotta give it some time. Give it some time. We got this. Jesus. We got this. We can do it. There we go. This is like the worst case of deja vu or a hell loop. My goodness. Jesus Christ. Man. Yeah, it's Groundhog Day. The thing is, though, I get it in the box, but it says it's not enough in the box for that acceleration there. Okay, I don't know how the hell that happened. You actually see it move in the right direction. Yeah, get in the action stream, save your stuff. Have pity on me. Okay, come on. Right, left, left, right. Okay, get in there. Yes! Oh, it's all the way over there. I have to make it all the way over there from a left turn. I got it. Here we go. Left, massive right, 2, 3. Right, left, left. Not enough left. Yes, once my windshield wipers. Jesus. If it were only that easy, London Less. We're only that easy. Got it. Oh, please get that one. Heck yeah. And somehow, somewhat inappropriate in-game music. But I did it. Thank you. Thank you, Vin. There's all the people who tortured me just now. Frickin' engineers. Breakneck speed as far as direction. My goodness.
Take it easy now. Have a nice day and see you soon.
Yeah. It was that one turbo that's all the way at the end of the screen. And Toei, of course, did the animation for this. Oh my goodness. Well, there you have it. Thank you. Okay, you're now annoying. 24 minutes ago, yes. Well, see, this took about as long as, Okay. Interesting.
Okay, now you've gotten annoying, so we'll just go ahead and let you go.
Ah, even worse. Okay. Yes, 24 minutes to go. Applesauce, thank you. Well, that's that. man. I think it took a little bit longer than Space Ace. But we did it. Absolutely. I have no idea what the beeping was. I had it on, not free mode, but there is a setting where you can have indefinite lives. Thank God. Because it doesn't continue like I would like to, so it's the only way we can do that. Oh man. Let's see, is there any other game in here that I can play that doesn't, like,
set alarms off or something like that.
Actually, there is. There is.
Watch your time.
Yep, gotta watch the time. I'm not gonna play much of this game. I'm gonna show you a game here called Mach 3. Thought your PC was gonna blow up? Yeah, tell me about it. Well, you should have heard
from
here.
I'm sorry?
I'm just going to start this one up real quick. I'm not going to actually play it. But I want to show off this real fast. So let's go ahead and hit start. Pretty much. Okay. It's going. Okay, let's take a look at the game real fast. It's actually going up through its things here. A preview for things to come, as we're in LaserDisc Mondays here in the month of March for 2023. Top brass. So you see, they still have the regular game graphics of that particular period. They just have an enhanced background of sorts. There is Mach 3. And as you can see, choose your game, take your bomber in under heavy enemy fire, or fly him low and fast in your fighter. Let's see what we got here. So again, they got computer graphic overlay or game overlay, and here you have a background. You shoot targets. More or less, tried FMB. In a way, yeah, this is kind of thing like the grandfather of full motion video. Rick Dyer, who was one of the principal people behind this, actually tried to make a home video system that uses this type of technology. It's called a Helicon. And of course, you know, the video game market in North America fell apart. But this thing with this way, as this is early day of full motion video in video games. This was amongst the first. Like I said, Dragon Slayer wasn't the first one, it was the first successful one to really get full motion video as a playable thing. And as you saw, this with Road Blaster, you can actually torture people with it. And they did so, and that was released in Japan. They never released it here until the home consoles started getting into the action, like the Sega CD and, like I said, the Pioneer Laser Active. Sound effects are annoying, and it just looks weird. It does, but you know what? That's something we get to look forward to. There was a game show back...
Next Monday,
right.
The 20th of March.
The 20th of March, indeed.
There was a game show back in the 80s, G4 used to show it when it was still on. It was called Starcade, and it would actually show these games, like Mach 3, Dragon Slayer, Cliffhanger even, and show off the newest games of the day. And like I said, it was an upcoming trend. It briefly revolutionized video gaming as we knew it. But, of course, like I said, there were some time things that didn't work its way. And when the market crashed in North America, now elsewhere around the world, it did okay. But it lost a lot of leverage. But here, no. It was, aside from arcades didn't suffer that much. But the home markets did. And that pretty much is that. And I think we're going to wrap it up here early tonight here, because I do have other places I get to be. And I want to thank you, Vin, for participating. Thank you, London Last, for being here with me as well. It's been a lot of fun. G4, I vaguely remember them for video game reviews. I think it was defunct in the 2000s. I'm not sure when G4 went off the air, to be honest with you. Honestly, because I didn't really watch it. That's probably part of the problem. Said, did you watch G4? Nah. Not at all. Especially, I don't know if it's 2000, mid-2000s, because I was still working for a major video game retailer in the mid-2000s. All right, thank you. Thank you, London Lass. For those who are watching the VOD, if you'd like what you saw, give me a follow. I greatly would appreciate it. I'm here 3 times a week. I'm here on Twitch, Monday nights, Thursday nights, and Saturday afternoons.
Like, subscribe!
Yeah, if you'd like what you saw, if you want to subscribe, feel free to do so as well. I also have a YouTube page of all the stuff that I've done in the past that is no longer here on Twitch. You can subscribe to that as well if you'd like. I also have the Match Game page. That's my first YouTube page. And I have an Instagram page of all the crap that I've collected over the last 4.5 decades gaming. That's really about it, isn't it? Ah, we had a good time. So, Thursday night, we're going to continue on and advance with The Secret of Mana, one of my favorite JRPGs from Squaresoft for the Super Nintendo, released 30 years ago, if you can believe that. And then, of course, we're going to have some Saturday afternoon gameplay goodness as well. We'll see you then. Thanks for being here, and I'll catch you all next time. Oh, don't forget, if you happen to like this kind of stuff as well, there's a Facebook page called the Retro Games Fan. You can sign up to it. You talk about games all the way up to the end of the last century. That was everything up to the Dreamcast and everything in between. Something to check out if you like that stuff. You can even show off what you've got, what you have, and see other people doing so as well. I did so back when the pandemic was getting started. So, and we can watch Biff and Buffy die. Yes, as we had repeatedly in the last couple of boss battles in Secret of Mana. Absolutely. I think that's about it. So we'll take it easy. No raid tonight. Y'all take care. Oh, by the way, I do have this little neat little nugget that I've been working on. See what you think when things go sideways in stream. I happen to like that one. But I might be of singular opinion. Oh, it will be. Oh, it will be. So that's when that's when everything decides to crash. So we'll see you then. All right, folks, have a good night. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.